Hi, Shiva Rajaya here from vitalcoaching.com. The topic for this video is, yes, it is all right, it is okay to give advice within the context of coaching sessions. So for those of you who started coaching relatively recently, you are as a coach giving sessions to people, you might wonder, you know, if it's okay to actually give advice and be very directive in the way you are offering reflection to somebody. So when I started coaching, that was close to 20 years ago, the traditional idea about coaching was to never ever give advice to somebody, to one of your clients. The idea was your client has all the answers. And why it's really beautiful in theory, on a practical level, that doesn't always work. When you're coaching somebody and that you know that you're going to have like 3 months of coaching with that person, and it's a process, it's an exploration of their own dynamics, and you know, you might have really the time and the container to explore really deep, it might be really helpful for you as a coach not to jump in too fast with advice. Okay, so that's one context, one situation. For me, what happens is that years back when I started coaching, I was offering like micro sessions, right? Sometimes I have 15 minutes with somebody because that's all the budget they can afford. That's all they will have. So they get on the phone with me and then we have a 15-minute laser coaching or targeted coaching session. So the way these sessions is going to work is that you need to deliver as much value as fast as possible to that person, because that might be the only window that you have with that specific client. So it's not the only situation where you will need to give advice. And sometimes advice, again, in a situation like this one is not appropriate, is not the thing that you have to do. But the point is this, it is that if you have, as a coach, 20 years of experience, let's say, for instance, in the field of digital marketing, right, online marketing or social media marketing, right, and you have been doing that for a long, long time, and you have a client who is just starting, right, without all this experience, they don't need to go through the 20 years of experience that you went through to actually gain the results that you are having today. You can shortcut and give them tips, advice, directions that is going to speed up their evolution and massively increase the speed at which they are learning and getting results. So sometimes, you know, you might argue that in a situation like that, we are more doing consulting than coaching. I don't really make, you know, too much micro distinctions about that. You know, the idea is this: you've got somebody and they need help, and you've got something as a coach that you can really help them with and be very direct and save them years and years of experimentation and trouble and sometimes danger. It's very useful to just go straight to the point, cut the chase and say, look, here is the system that I feel works the best for me. Here's what I tried. I took these 5 steps and this is the system that I developed and this is how it works the best for me. If you, when you meet a coach, a client who might be in this situation and what you say to them is something like, I hear what you're saying. And I'm sure that you have all the answers. So right now, what does your intuition tell you to do? And then they might have, you know, your client might have a hint, they might have an idea, and then they might start exploring and try to redesign or reinvent the wheel. But that's going to be a long, long, long process. If you already have that experience, this 20 years experience in a certain field, just cut the chase and go straight to the point. This doesn't mean that what you're offering is going to be applicable to them, but it means that at least you have a system or an advice or something of value that is really powerful to them. A client is going to hire you because you know how to communicate, because you know how to hold space, you know how to listen, you know how to validate, you know how to stay present, you know how to prioritize their situation. But they will also hire you because you have a wide range of expertise on certain topics. And this expertise means that it's going to to speed up their evolution and allow them to get to results much faster. I can give you another example. For instance, imagine that I have been climbing the Everest 20 times and I explore different routes. I know that there is lots of danger zones over there. You have to be really careful with that. And a client comes and tells me, I want to climb the Everest and I need your help. You know, as a coach, I'm not going to say to them, well, you know, start walking in that direction and you will figure it out. And as you feel the steps that you're taking, you will get intuitively the feeling if you are on the right track or not. And as soon as you see bad weather, maybe listen to the signs and, you know, give like something that would be really vague. What does your intuition tell you to do? What do you know you have to do? You know, this exploration, this coaching exploration is really powerful and it works really well in lots of situations. Now, when it comes to something that is practical like this one, then the highest value that this client can receive from me is for me to be very direct. It's like, you've got five routes, five possible directions and ways to get to the summit. The first three ones are extremely dangerous. The second, the two next ones, you need a team. You need oxygen, blah, blah, blah. You know, give the advice. Here are the pathways. Here are the maps. And give very targeted advice on how to get there. So if we bring that within a context which is more coaching, for instance, relationship coaching, right? Communication with your partner, for instance. And I see that my client is making the same mistake over and over again in the way they are communicating with their lover or their partner, right? If I see they're making that mistake, I would step in and say, look, is it okay if I offer you some reflection on what I see is happening right now? And if they give me permission, then I would say, if you shift that communication pattern right now that you're utilizing, which is blaming, for instance, your partner or being angry or being reactive, and you pause and you listen, the outcome is going to be very different. Let's try. So what I gave right now is directive, targeted feedback or advice. I'm encouraging my client to do something that I have been practicing and that I have the feeling works really well. So here we go. The answer or the code, the core tip for this video is yes, it's totally okay to give advice within a coaching session. Now, not always, okay, not all the time. Sometimes the advice that you might give might be just a projection of your own agenda and be forceful into a client's field. But, you know, you have to be subtle in the way you use it. Sometimes the best way to help somebody is to let them figure out their answers and their own pathway, because in this exploration is going to be really powerful. So you've got those different strategies. It doesn't mean that you have to all the time give advice or never give advice. You can play with that and intuitively tune in to when it is appropriate to give an advice. There is a coaching mistake, which is jumping in with advice too soon. I'm going to do another video on that as well. But so that you know, if you have been a purist within the coaching field and you don't know if it's okay to actually step in and be directive within the context of coaching sessions, when I'm directive personally within the context of coaching sessions, most of the times we get to results really, really fast. It saves us lots of time and trouble and kind of wandering around, getting trapped in labyrinths of exploration and being like, I explore that. Let's cut the chase and go straight to the point. Here are three things that I think are going to work really well in your situation. If you apply that, my belief is that you have 80% chances of solving the challenge that you are facing right now. Okay? So this is it for this tip. I hope you have a great day. I'll see you soon for another video.